Wake up! You're sleeping all day. I'm going for sport. Mom and Dad asked about me, tell him the same.
Okay, but please come back on time.
To breastfeed you, you see. Hey, by the way, where's my phone?
I'm at the studio. I'm doing my phone as usual. Okay. Okay, you know, Oye, can I call you back in about, say, 10 minutes? Okay, baby. Alright. Okay, let me see.
If not what?
Are you saying that they will eventually not get married? Is that what you're saying?
What I'm insinuating, my dear, is that an apple in the bush has so many eyes staring at it. Just look at this girl. Look at this girl. She has excess of every quality that a man should desire in a woman. And now, as a mother, she has showcased herself to the eyes of all men, wide and near. Do you think your son is the only man who has his eyes on her? Do you think so?
Honey, you're scaring me. Frankly, you're scaring me. Are you saying that Junior is not able to protect her, even with your interest as the king? Is that what you're saying?
There you go again. My influence, my influence, my influence. That is exactly the mentality that has been ruling his attitude.
After all, my father is the king, and because everybody calls him the prince.
Is that the criteria to win a woman's heart? Is that? Let me tell you something, my dear. There are thousands of young men out there whose fathers might not be kings, but they are capable of buying the king and his palace.
Hello, Albert.
Dad.
Yes.
My wild long face is what is going on.
Oh no.
This is beautiful, mother. How come you never mentioned it to me? This is really, really nice, honestly.
Look at Chisa, she looks really beautiful in this picture.
Come on, Dad. I mean, we should be celebrating this and not mourning. Why the long face?
Oh, yes, my son, you are right. We should be celebrating her stardom. But the point here is this. How serious are you while celebrating her?
Father, I don't quite follow. Dad, I don't understand.
Tell me, how serious is your relationship with Jesus?
We are serious. Don't we look serious?
Listen, my son. You see, your mother and I were discussing your relationship with her before you walked in. Now tell me, when are you settling down with that girl?
What's funny? You see, what's funny about what your father just said?
You see what I told you? It's not serious. He's not even considering it at all.
I'm sorry, Dad. I'm really, really sorry, Mother. I'm sorry. You have to forgive me for laughing, but is that the reason for the tension? Huh? Dad, I'm a young man. It's not on my priority list for now, Father.
Listen, my son, age has got nothing to do with marriage. Rather, the content of the characters that are involved in marriage. Do you love her? Do you have the mutual understanding to tolerate each other's state? Anytime, anywhere, any day, do you have that? Then if you have that, age has got nothing to do about it. After all, I married your mother at the age of 25. And then I was still in school.
Father, don't start.
You have no excuse at all. You don't have any excuse.
Dad, don't walk yourself. Honestly, if you ask me, I think we should rest this topic for now. And this is really nice. We should be celebrating Jesus right now. And not fighting ourselves as a family. Why don't I just look for her and probably arrange for the both of us to have dinner later tonight and celebrate. This is really, really nice. Oh, this is nice. Great! See you soon.
What's up?
How you doing?
I'm good.
What's happening?
Chilling, man, bro.
How many points do I have to call up?
3 good points. You think I can do that? You're a dreamer. See, I'll get my balance today. No stories.
Too bad, man. Too bad.
Okay.
You know what I'm going to be doing today?
What?
I'm going to be hitting you 7 good points.
Me?
7 good points. And you know what you're doing? You are going to subtract and balance me at the end of the game.
Just like that. So simple.
Exactly.
You know what I like about you?
What?
I like the fact that you talk and you blab so much. That's just the same we talked about Laura being your wife without no actions to back it up.
Hey, Danny.
Yeah.
Don't talk about Laura like that, please. Yeah. See, I have my plans and strategies for Laura.
Spare me those plans and strategies, my brother. Listen, the power of plan is action. You think I'm the only one that admires Laura? Just pray I don't pick up my pen and write about her someday.
Okay, Mr. Executor. Just leave my Laura out of it. You can concentrate on that your model.
Yeah.
Just concentrate on her. Leave my Laura out of it, okay? That reminds me. Any clue about her?
She's, you know me now. I know if you do, you know.
I trust you.
And let me see her. And okay. I heard she's dating the prince.
Too bad, man. No way for you this time around!
Why?
Because she's dating the prince.
Even if she's dating the president. I don't care.
Are you're not serious, Danny. I think you want to die. Must you write about every girl in town?
Yes.
Okay, so what could be the title of the script this time around? How to covet the princess?
Listen, the answer's for nothing. I have less than 7 days to complete the script. And once I'm done writing it, you're gonna see that girl by the side of my car. But.
But what?
But if I don't write about Laura first.
Are you alright? Are you crazy?
Come on, get into the car.
Don't! You try
get
me!
Get into the car!
Don't
try
me!
Oh my god. Oh, Laura's gonna be in my back in car.
I heard you.
You're gonna imagine.
That easy.
You're gonna imagine Laura sweating on my bed, right? Are you okay?
I'm gonna be all over her, man.
You can.
Yeah.
You know me. You know me too well.
But you know what to write about your girl. Not your girl anyway. Not about Laura. She's gone.
She's gone.
Yeah, she's gone. Oh, all you do is talk and make plans and blab and stuff.
All right. Let's see how it goes.
You don't have action, man. A good action, bro.
Let's see how it goes. See, just leave Laura for me, please.
Why is that?
Don't go anywhere. Don't go near her.
Have you married her?
Leave Laura for me, please.
Laura, key. Come on,
she's
my
future. I love her so much.
She's your future partner. She's my groupie.
Your groupie. I'll castrate you.
I love this.
Madam, if they para, you won't be slapping me. Now, when I don't come down, His friend's girlfriend played with his father's emotions and duped his mom, all for the same girl.
Please,
No, you listen. I am sick and tired of Dad always accusing me of covering up for you and your games. Meanwhile, I am the one who has been left out from the truth.
What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about, Danny. You don't tell me about your business. I don't know anything about you.
How would you disappoint me? You know everything about me. You know where I go. You know the things I want to do. You know everything.
I don't know anything about you. I literally have to dig up for every piece of information.
What?
Okay.
Why didn't you tell me that you were going to abandon Mom in the market and go after your friend's girlfriend? And why didn't you tell me that you were going to dupe Mom of her money, all in the pretense of helping her fix the car? You are not going to deny it, are you? Because it's there in your laptop and I read every single bit of it. Danny, you acted everything perfectly well today. You're writing, you're acting. Wow, bro. Thumbs up. Well done. You're the pro, bro.
I don't know if I'm a mysterious child or it's just a mere coincidence, but I've come to realize that whatever I put down to write is something the future gives me the privilege to actualize. What I don't understand is the relationship between my right outside and the future course of action. I can't explain it. And even though sometimes I do it, I just don't enjoy it.
You guys were best friends. How could you do that, Danny?
Hello, girlfriend. How you doing? I'm sorry. I got home late and tired, and I'm sorry about it. Anyway, I got Mom's yours sorted out yesterday. It was fine. I told you I was sorted out, right? No. I played my game perfectly well. And right now I'm with my sister. I'm talking to her about you. So maybe she'll come around tomorrow for an acquaintance. For nothing. All right, just go to bed. I'll talk in the morning, okay? All right.
for real? On a Saturday morning?
On a Saturday morning. My boss called me yesterday and said we are going to the new branch of the Phantom House to fix their network today.
Wow.
But this IT job is very hectic. I'm very, very tired.
Listen, bro, it's the same thing everywhere. But as long as the money is involved,
money.
No problem.
Money, money. Then it was the zest of money without freedom.
Look, money buys freedom. Oh, but I believe in no time you will find someone to help with your moving around, okay?
You're right, that's true. That's true. Danny, guess what?
What?
I am going to propose to her today.
Propose to who?
Laura, of course.
Oh.
Oh, man, Danny, there is no time anymore. I have been able to study her, know her kind of person, know what she likes and what she doesn't like,
okay.
Her friends and her enemies. I think it's the right time for me to make this move. Don't you think so?
I think so, certainly, because, I mean, you've just been talking with no actions to, you know, to match with the words. So I think it's a good thing. Go ahead and do it. Congrats, man.
It's actually, I was just willing to study her very well, to know her kind of person, to know who she really is before I can make this move. But I think this is the right thing. Are you going with me?
No, I can't. Listen, I don't think it's right for me to be a part of it. You know, it's something you need to go and do alone. Don't you think so?
Oh, yeah. That is true, Danny. It's true. And I love that girl. I really love her. I want to settle down with her. I pray it works, Danny.
Well, I'm happy, and I'm happy for you that at least you can put to actions your words. Let's take it forever. Anyway, congrats. I wish you the best of the night. Why don't you start going before it gets too late?
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
I have to run along.
Alright, cool. Alright, just drop me on.
Okay.
Last job because we're trying to plan how to execute it, and your sister, she died in the hospital because you were procrastinating taking her to a better place for treatment. Come on, it's okay to think your thoughts are true, but not when you allow procrastination to creep into you. Don't you get it? And I've told you before, and I'll tell you again. If you do nothing about Laura, I'll pick up my pen.
Hey, stop it, Danny! Don't you ever try it! I will never ever forgive you if you write anything stupid about my Laura. Get that in your head, Danny!
Idea is you can get this old negative thought out of your system, and I'm working on that. I take.
Don't you think Mona loves you more? Don't get me wrong, it's not like I hate you or anything, but the truth is I can never have you. So I suggest you give him a chance.
I only blame my friend that keeps procrastinating and wanting to talk to you about stuff. Mana wants to propose to you, but the truth is he keeps changing dates and timing because he was not sure of your response, so as not to get embarrassed.
Wait! What is wrong with you? You passed my bus stop now.
Olga, you don't know your adults, man. I'll be you this time.
Are you mad? I not tell you where they go before.
See, this one where we did drive up and down, like me, I don't feel collect 500 naira. My money na 800 naira.
800 naira. You know, like 1 million naira. Don't buy big, I go my house.
Me, I don't talk now. I know if you collect 500, my money na 800 naira.
See, this next street there is my junction. So please just go.
You mean 300 naira?
Take this one first now.
Well, my money remains 300 naira. See, after all this one, we don't drive up. Yeah, I know if you collect for 8,500. My money is 800 naira.
See, you know what, driver? This 500 naira I just gave to you is the only thing I have both here and inside this house. Unless you want to come and take my bulldog for 300 naira.
Go, go, punish you. I lie, no. We need baby. My money never come. My money remains 300 naira. God go punish you. What about Shin Lo? What you know, Lord? Then, what more do? To say a very big thank you, rather a special thank you to all the management and staff of this Donald Integrated Systems Limited. And thank you all. And as you can see, I have retired as the managing director of this company. I'm handing over the affairs of this company to my son here, Daniel, and my beloved daughter, Daisy. And let there be no reason for anyone to disobey them. You understand? Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Daisy.
Congratulations, Daisy.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah. So we're not going to disobey anybody here, we're going to work as one.
Thank you.
still not cheerful. I don't like this mood of yours.
Barbara, honestly, I'm confused. I mean, I couldn't believe my ears when he was saying all these words. How could Danny leave me all because of his friend?
Are you serious? See, Danny is only being sincere to you. I mean, I don't believe such guys still exist. If it were all that they would have used you and dumped you, what would you do? You only end up losing your precious commitments. Right? Anyway, Mana's gonna make a good replacement for him. Really.
I lost it because I love him. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's such a coward. And what would you call someone like that? Who can only start what he cannot finish? I mean, he shouldn't have come to me in the first place if he knows he's not going to stay with me. And now that I've given him my heart, he's running away with it.
You should be grateful that you only gave him your heart and not your body.
I would have been happy if he had had my body.
Laura. Laura.
Yes?
Do you know what your problem is?
What?
You're in love. Yes!
You can say that again.
Mana's gonna make a good replacement.
You think it's that easy? Dating two friends, one after another?
Oh, please stop deceiving yourself. You guys were just friends. And I'm sure Danny sees it that way. Anyway, I have an appointment to catch.
With who?
And why that look of yours?
Come out with it. I'm not in the mood.
Okay. Anyway, you think I'm going to see Danny? You know, there's a friend of mine who's a model. We need to go and meet her agent so we can negotiate some things, you know?
Okay, so when am I going to see you again?
Maybe next tomorrow, I'm not sure. Depends on what.
Hello? Now listen, Mr. Harrison. Mr. Harrison, now listen. Do you know, this is the second time you are working on that network under 1 month. Do you know how much you're costing me? Do you know? Oh, you are sorry, huh? You are sorry. I think I have to get another engineer because I can see that you're not serious. Look, you are very serious. Oh, now you are ready to do it, eh? I told you to plant two of your boys in that business office, but you wouldn't listen. Oh, I think I have to get another engineer because I see that you're not serious. See, you are very silly. You're very silly. Nonsense.
I'm writing.
You're writing? When did you become the secretary of the company?
That's not to do with the company. I'm writing a script.
You're writing a script? Why the network connection in your office is in bad shape? Danny, is it how you're going to run the company, Danny? No wonder. It is because you are not there. That is why they're calling me at home to report issues from your office. Hi. What a shame. What a shame.
Yeah, Daddy, I'm sorry. I'll sit to that now. I'll ensure that it's been fixed up.
Better do that now. Get inside.
Excuses! What is wrong with you? Are you incompetent of your own job? There's always talk about network this, network that, when a supposed IT manager is on ground to oversee them.
No, I'm sorry, sir. As you can see, I've brought on the boys to visit. I'm really sorry, sir.
Yes, sir. Actually, the chief demanded for me to bring two of my boys to monitor this thing constantly, and Mama is one of the guys about to stay around. I'm sorry for what has happened, sir. I'm sorry for the inconvenience, sir. It will never happen again, sir.
Network failure will not occur again. I can't stand Mr. Donald's son.
No, nothing like that, sir. Nothing like that. We've been able to upgrade the server. Cables are renewed. So, we have no fear.
Notwithstanding, I need to stay close to monitor this on a daily basis. And I've chosen you and Maxwell to work. You get it, and you report at the office on Fridays.
But sir, is it necessary I'm here with Maxwell? He alone can handle it. I don't have to be here with him, sir.
Chief Denner chose the both of you to work for him, and it's to your advantage.
Sir, sorry. I don't think I want to be here. I mean, I can come in and go in like that. I don't want to stay here permanently, sir.
Is there something you're not telling me?
Something like what, sir?
I suspect there is something between you and Chief Denner's son.
Sir, nothing, no. Nothing. Absolutely nothing, sir.
Then they're not going to change my authority. I am the boss. You get it? My this is the final. You're staying.
Can you bring up your sinister? Okay, what are we going to face? Are you okay? What?
That's why I'm here.
What is it?
Danny, you have not been executing your duties in the office. And Dad is greatly worried. You don't care about what goes on in your own office. All you do is script writing and executing them. Danny, you are the one to take over from Dad and his entities. Just look at the kind of attitude that you are putting towards your own business.
My own business?
Yes!
This is my business. This is... Come on, why can't everybody just understand that this is what I want to do? This is my thing. Please.
Sure, this is what you want.
Listen. I love you. I love you so much. I love you because there is really no one else to call a brother or a sister. And when you talk like this, I know it's because you're not happy, but I'm trying my best. I'm trying everything I can to be there for the business and everything. Okay, I promise this from henceforth, I'm going to execute my official duties properly, but not to the detriment of my dream and aspiration. Okay, I'll try to do everything at once. I promise.
I'm somehow happy.
Somehow happy? You should be happy all the way.
You said you can carry everyone along, right?
Yes, of course. I can and I will. Promise.
Okay, cool. So tell me. So what's your script about?
Trust me, this is both interesting and intriguing. It's actually tied to the treasure of a blind prince. You should go through this!
Okay.
Alright, I'm so...
Hi, honey. How are you? Come on, baby. Why are you talking like this? Your joblessness is not part of it. You need to calm down. Calm down. Listen, my brother is not aware that you got sacked from his office because you refused to work there. Okay? And neither in his greatest imagination does he think that I, his sister, will ever have anything to do with you. And babe, I promise not to tell him anything. When he finds out, he will know that you are not that dolphin that he thinks that you are. Well, you guys are best pals. It's none of my business. But I do not know how he would react when he finds out that we're seeing each other. You're wrong. Think about you, baby. I love you too. Bye, good night, baby.
And before we toast, I have a special drink from the barman to get for both of them.
Yes,
sir. Barman,
sir,
please get us 2 glasses of wine for my prince and my princess. Well, I want you to feel free. It is day. You host us.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Make it snappy.
Yeah, so.
All right. Have a glass. Have a glass.
All right.
Yeah. So, we're going to toast. Prince. You got cold toast.
Can I go, sir?
Oh, you're free.
Oh, well, what can I say, ladies and gentlemen? We get up every day trying to make something out of our lives, which in turn, excuse me, darling, are you here? Which in turn does not allow us to meet and chat. Our place and giving time, what you want to call gathering and drop minds, and you know, sometimes relax, just unwind and have fun. But it is quite good that we're here today. So, in the light of that, I'll say let's toast.
Yep.
Yes.
All right. So, Prince, how did it go?
Beautiful, beautiful. By the way, I was going to ask you. Forgive me if I underestimated you at first, but when you kept hounding me about coming here, I didn't know it was really this nice. I was just telling you, my princess, that I am quite impressed with the work that you have done here. This is nice. This is really nice.
To me? What have I done to myself? I can't believe this. What?
What is that drug doing in his pockets? Could it be that he has drugged me? Oh no, Prince! Oh no! How could you do this to me? What would be your reason for doing this?
Hello, miss. Oh, you are the lady that was drugged last night.
Who are you?
Why are you crying? Listen, he never meant to kill you, hurt you, okay? I assume he never expected that lady would show up last night. So he tried to keep you away for a while, okay?
Who are you?
Well, I'm the bar attendant. Just monitor him, follow him, know his whereabouts, okay? Well, can I go back to bed?
Please excuse me. Can I... How do I get the safe for this camera you're talking about?
For the camera, it's not possible. Because it might be jeopardizing your emotion the more. Why don't you...
Please, I beg you. I need to know the person I'm dealing with. Look, my life could be at risk.
Yes, your life could be at risk, okay? Because if not for my boss's son that was here last night, who knows what could have happened to you? Huh? He was the one that took you in last night when he left you. And let her call him back when the lady have left. So.
So, how can I see your boss? Can I get the tape?
Well, I won't say anything for now. But for that boy, what he did last night was terrible. It's a serious case that can charge him to court. Okay?
Look, I just want to see your boss, okay? I can handle this myself.
Well, I'm not saying that he's going to be charged to court, okay? But for my chairman, I will call him to know when he's going to be free to see you because he knows he's a busy guy.
Okay, but can I see him next week, like Tuesday?
So, who will I tell him that he's looking for him?
Shiza. My name is Shiza.
Shiza. Nice name. Do you have any other name?
They call me Princess. Definitely is a kid.
Oh, Princess. And your boyfriend is Prince and the father a king, I presume?
He's not my boyfriend. And yes, his father is a king.
Alright, no problem. But all I have to tell you is be careful, monitor him, okay? You can go in and take care of yourself.
Unbelievable. I still find it very amazing. The prince to drug me. What if I haven't confirmed from this barman? I would have still been doubting if he actually drugged me after what I saw in his pockets. What could really be his reason? Could it be he wants to take advantage of me or because of a girl came around to be with him? He claimed he loved me, so he's been deceiving me all this while. Till I get to see this, his boss, I need to see that tape and hear from him what really happened.
Thank you.
Oh, come on, don't be silly. You have to come and wait for me. Meanwhile, you're better off.
No, just left. I will give you a glass.
Adams! Adams!
Boss! Hey, hey, hey! Young one! Okay, sir.
Hello, sir.
Prince, I was busy inside.
Chisa, your behavior has been out of place for some time now. I don't know what is going on. Since the last party, you've been acting. You don't talk to me. You don't visit me. You don't even care how I feel. Chisa, I am rotten. All right? This isn't working very well with me, and that's why I'm here to get answers. Why are you like this? Look, I know that I might have offended you unconsciously without knowing, but darling, there are better ways of handling issues. All right? The last I remember, you were the one who deserted me in a hotel room and left without answers. And here I am, wanting to hear your side of the story. What is happening?
Look, right now, I'm very, very busy, okay? Look, I have my car to service, and my dad just called me to come see him, okay? I'll be leaving town any moment from now, so don't bother come checking on me, okay?
And you don't think it is important for us?
Danny, where are you? Are you not supposed to be in the warehouse by now? They called me that container just arrived and you're nowhere to be found. Movie what? Danny, are you silly? Are you... Look, I am talking about taking the inventory of the new product and you're here talking about a product that worth over 100 million naira and you're there talking about... Are you okay? What is this? What are you talking about? Look, young man, this is the end of discussion until you get back home. Do I make myself clear?
Good story though, quite interesting.
but the mystery behind the imaginary write-up and the occurrence of it is what baffles me. Why must nature give him the opportunity to execute whatever his magic pen and idea creates? Is my brother a mischievous child? Well, I'll find out what happened by the end of the story.
I need to call Mana. Yes.
Just your friend is seeing my friend. And they both love each other. I'm cool with that. It has happened. You can't blame Zara. Even Danny himself can't blame him. See, it has happened. He is my friend. But there is nothing I can do about him.
Mana, really, sincerely, you're not being fair to yourself. You're not being sincere to yourself. I know that you and Danny are in worlds apart. And Danny is no longer with Laura. Danny is no longer with Laura, surprise it. Yes. In fact, Laura is hot right now. She's hot because of the gimmicks your friend put her through. Look, Mana, if ever you feel anything for Laura, this is the right time to resuscitate that passion.
There is something you don't understand. See, love is temperamental and whimsical. When it comes, enjoy it. And when it goes, wave at it. Am I going to kill myself? It has happened, it has happened. There is nothing I can do about it. Though I loved her so much. I loved Laura so very much, which everybody knows. I loved her so much that I wanted something deeper with her. Fine. There's nothing I can do.
So I guess you're seeing someone else. Right? I guess you're seeing someone else. Wait a minute. Are you going out with Shiz?
I beg your pardon, Barbara. What's the meaning of that? How can you talk to me like that? Oh, because I gave you an audience? Does that give you the audacity to talk to me anyhow?
I'm sorry. Privacy,
please.
Privacy. Sorry.
Okay, it's okay. I wasn't acting like a capon here. Did I scare you?
Scared. You really scared me. I wish you could see the looks in your eyes. Jesus.
That's how we do it. That's how we do it when you want to get something. Straight, but I am innocent. I'm not bad. I'm innocent. That reminds me. Who is this Shiza? Is she a princess?
Oh, come on! Don't give me that look, Abra.
Come on! Don't give me that look, Abra. Is she dating the prince?
Bravo. So tell me more about her,
Barbara. Where are you going, Barbara?
From her question, one can easily figure out that the so-called Shiza is no longer dating the prince. This simply means that Danny has written on her. Oh my goodness. What manner of human is this boy? Why is he particularly concerned in destroying relationships? Now he has abandoned Laura and subjected Shiza and prints into the victim of his mischievous pen. It's hard to believe that Danny is not under a certain abnormal influence. This is serious.
German song, Danny.
Yes,
you've been now, sorry.
You're going to come in, right? It's okay, you're here now.
A few more things to do, and I'm sorry we can't really talk here, you know, because I have some things to go to the warehouse. TC, you're going to move me to the warehouse. I have a couple of things to do there, okay? Your appointment's the old, all right? And talk to your people. I heard your boss is around.
What do I have to do in the warehouse?
TC, when we get there, you'll know. Alright? I'm sorry, we can't really talk here. So, on our way, can you do that? Huh? Alright,
let's go. Alright, we'll meet you. Then
we'll talk
to you. Alright. Come, girls. I'll be going out now. I want you to take care of everything, okay?
So, where are you going to?
Why must you know? Well, you're right, but both of them are not coming around, okay? Tell Akeem that off with Danny, all right? Make sure you take care of everything.
Yes, sir. This Danny to the people, pompous. The way he used to carry himself, they face me, eh? See the way he just come carry manager, see if you have nothing to do here.
What do you expect? Someone who is in control of everything. I want to see on top of the road. I beg, leave the for Jarry.
Okay, now you go know that they kind of find they go now.
Who's it? To the police. You go my office next.
What? I'm not now. It's okay. What about the movement with Shiza?
I'm going to the National Theatre. I'm going to find you with Shiza. So, I'll bring along my phone to the
Or do you like her now?
I don't. I don't know. You're already there. I'm only following your footsteps. TC is innocent.
All right, take care of yourself.
All right,
There's this thing we do when we were young.
God!
Of course, even the devil shall have it.
Thank you.
What's happening? Why the noise?
We don't know, ma. We don't know, my
friend. Where is the prince?
He just walked in a while ago.
Shiza, don't tell me you're not expecting my call.
Well, are you about to be in bed by now? Are you still worried about it?
On the contrary, I have long forgotten about that incident. Though I never expected him to be cheating on me, but thanks for your concern anyway. I don't really know what to say to you. He's not seeing properly. I mean, what do you mean? Can I see it tomorrow? Please.
Mercy on your soul.
Mr. Harris, good evening, sir. Fine, very fine, sir. Actually, as you can see, I'm going to the side to face.
You are the next going one. To the side.
That means you've not done it. Yes, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Hey, sir! What have you been doing all day?
Like I said,
so you're waiting for them to actually put a structure before you put on the network?
I'm sorry,
really?
Sir. Like I said to you, I'm going to. You know what, Mr. Harrison?
Are you okay? You sound awkward. No, Grok. This is also serious. Please, I need one of your IT men to come to my office immediately. I'm having problems with our local network and our customers are beginning to complain. Danny, you know what? Please send Mana to my office because I can trust his skills. Do you understand? Danny, do you hear me? Alright, bro, I'm waiting. Thanks. By now, Danny will be wondering where Mana is. And I'll get my baby back to work. Mana, I wish you just understand how much I love you. And stop suspecting that I'm with someone else. Danny, I wonder how you feel when you find that I, your sister, is dating your own friend. But I'm sure you'll understand, dear brother, because you have been the player. And now you will know what it feels like to be played. That reminds me, brother. After we finish the story.
Yes, hello. Who is this? I meet you at a bar. Who are you?
Who the hell do you think? Speak to me in that manner. Who are you? God! God!
Are you Prince?
And who are you?
Well, my master is waiting for you over there.
Who is your master?
Why don't you find out? Come with me.
After you.
What is this about?
My friends, calm down and let me explain.
Excuse me? Excuse, you want me to calm down? Now is it for drugging my fiancé in a club? Caressing her, taking her into a room and making love to her? Huh? As if for snatching my woman from me and then parading her around town like she's yours? Young man, tell me to which do you want me to carry on? And above all that, you had the effrontery to write some piece of note and send to my house. Who the hell do you think you are? Huh? Who the hell do you think you are? Who the hell do you think you are? Talk to me like right now, like a man. Who the hell do you think you are?
Get out!
What a country! Now, right now, I feel so much rage. So much rage to hear the black man to man. But guess what? I won't do that. You're the prince, the heir apparent to the kingdom. I'll give you a piece of advice. If you love the princes like you claim you do, listen to the word of your father. Go and make up your wife and stop procrastinating. If you don't do that, I'll come after you. Trust me, I'm not going to physical fights, but I'll make you feel pain. I'll make you feel the excruciating pain.
Ikenna, you are my only child, and an only son for that matter. You can see that both time and age are no longer on my side. Should I join my ancestors tomorrow, you are the one and only heir to this throne. And judging by the custom and tradition of our people, no prince will ever mount this throne unmarried. Therefore, it is required of you to bring home a girl for marriage. Bring home your wife so that we can bless both of you and get you prepared to take over from me. I have said this before. At 25, I was in school, yet I married your mother. She gave birth to you 2 years after our marriage. Again, I took over from my father. I wasn't your age. I know why I'm saying all this. Time and pride, they say, do not wait for any man. Make haste while the sun shines, my son. A word, they say, is enough for the wise. Again, I want to carry my grandchildren. Help me.
Listen, I don't intend to complain, though. I mean, since mom and dad left town, I've already had the proper mail. Is something bothering you?
Danny, I know I should tell you if anything is bothering me, but I'm fine.
Sweetie, but I said I'm sorry. I'm truly sorry. See, every man is guilty of one mistake or the other. I mean, anyone have fallen apart somehow. You see, any man that has never fallen, I swear to you, will never rise again when he falls. Believe me.
This is not why you brought me here.
Yes. My boss was here a few days ago. He came here looking tensed and very scared, begging me to return to the office and resume my duties immediately.
So what was your response?
What else? I told him to give me some time to think about it. But he wanted me to come with him immediately.
Listen, you will reject the offer.
What?
Listen, you will tell him you are no longer interested, irrespective of what he offers.
Desi, are you kidding me? For crying out loud, I'm a jobless man. And this man is offering me a 100% increment to my former salary, an official car, even with all the packages he talked about.
I know he promised you heaven and earth. He promised to give you the whole world. Come on, Mana. I wish you know how much I love you.
Lizzie, what are you talking about?
You see, I was planning not to tell you anything until I am done with what I want to do. But now I have to tell you to calm your curiosity. You see, Mama, I have been studying my father's budget for IT. I realized that your boss has over 250 million naira allocated to him per annum. You know the job very well. You can be your own boss and recruit people to work for you. You see, I have a plan. I have a plan to kick away Mr. Harrison from my father's business treasures so that you can take over the contract.
What? How do you think this will work, Desi? I mean, considering your brother's opinion and your father's opposition, perhaps. How will it work?
Mana, forget about my father. I am the first child and only daughter of the family. You see, my brother and I is now fully in charge of my father's business. Okay? So we make the decision. Because I don't think that your friend Danny would be happy to know that you are no longer working in the office that he is fully in charge of.
Wait, baby. Are you serious? Sweetie, you mean this will work?
Of course it will, man.
Wait, baby. Are you serious? Like, seriously, this will work? Oh, God. I'm so happy. Sweetie, my darling. Sweetie, it will work. Oh, God. I love you. I love you.
Come on, Daddy! Come on, baby! Stop it!
Danny? That's my brother's voice. I wonder what they could be discussing. What's he doing here?
What the fuck?
actually amazing. Wow. When will I be this popular in modeling?
It won't be long, baby. It won't be long. Just be positive about. Sorry. Excuse me. Oh, baby, how are you? I miss you. No, but how could I forget such experience easily? So what are you feeling like? Okay. I'll see you soon. Okay, bye.
And princess, you're the luckiest girl in the world. I mean, I wish we can exchange destiny, honestly.
What do you mean?
Listen, my princess, you are a supermodel and your multimillionaire father is a king, and here you are having a handsome prince as a fiance. I wish I'm in your shoes.
Then you'll get choked in that shoe. Look, Barbara, I know I've never made mention of this to you before, but please, I don't ever want to hear that name again. Talk of referring to him as my fiance. Have you heard me?
My princess, why do you sound so hot and bitter? I am your friend and you can trust me. What has the prince done to us such words from you? And I know that call you received was not from him. I know so.
Look, Barbara, I don't ever want you to mention that name again. And right now, I'm not ready to talk about it. Okay?
Okay.
So sweet. I'm telling you, I really liked it. It was really nice.
Oh, princess. What about the prince?
Right.
Since the last time I visited, she's not really talked about him that much.
Look, girlfriend. I've told you, I don't want to talk about the prince. Okay?
I don't get it. I thought we're supposed to be best friends. We're supposed to be close friends. We share secrets. So why are you hiding talking about the prince to me? I'm supposed to be your friend, remember?
Baby, you're more like a sister to me, okay? But look, there are some things that are better left unsaid, okay? And this is just one of it. I'm not ready to talk about it.
Princess, I know the prince loves you so much. I mean, this guy is dying for you. How can you just neglect a man with such caliber?
Oh, really? So, if I may ask my girlfriend, how then do you know the prince loves me? Oh, are you now one of the girls that have been flaunting their asses around him?
Princess. Are you suspecting me with the prince? Because I want what's best for you and the prince?
Accuse you? For crying out loud, today the prince, tomorrow the prince, every day the prince. All I hear is the prince loves you. He doesn't prove that to me. I don't get it. How then do you know the prince loves me?
You
even though you've been...
You lie. I'm leaving. I'm just taking a cab. God, you're so mean. Enjoy yourself. slept with Chris after flaunting my ass around him.
Oh, come on, Barbara. Must you always dwell in the past? Eh? You know I didn't mean it that way.
Oh, really? Maybe what you meant is maybe I'm the one responsible for what happened to you and the prince.
Barbara. I'm so sorry the way I spoke to you the other day, okay? I'm really so sorry. But can we just forget this talk about Prince here and Prince there? Must always be topic of discussion.
Yes. Yes, he should be. Until you tell me what his offenses are and who is occupying your mind.
Ah, baby. Now I'll tell you who is occupying my mind. And after that, we can talk about any other thing. So come on with me. Come on, please.
I need to speak to you right now. Okay, okay. I'll be right there in a minute. Hold on, just wait for me.
I think you have to go back to your office now.
Are you my boss?
No, I am not your boss.
What?
I told you somebody wants to see me now. The lady that called me well the other time.
Yes, she is.
She is one of the victims of your brother's mischievous pains. I'm sure she wants to be a complaint.
Oh. Danny wrote about her.
Danny wrote about her. And even took her boyfriend from her. I'm sure she has discovered it was all a fling after all.
Well, she should just move on. Or better still, look for someone else.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That easy. Just like I did when he wrote on me and Laura, right?
Yeah, that reminds me. Where's Laura?
I think I heard she's out of town now. Somewhere, I don't know. What's funny? See you laughing now. You can now see how your brother is frustrating people. Eh?
Please. It's none of my business. I don't want to be a party to it at all.
Really?
Okay? Yes.
Okay.
Anyways, I have to run now.
Alright then.
Please help me!
Expect me to believe all you have said.
I couldn't believe it myself when I saw both of you yesterday, which prompted me to move immediately to see his friend Mana, who was dating my friend Laura. Before Danny wrote on how to separate both of them, it was even yesterday that Mana told me about this magic writing and how he plans on separating you and the prince. Why this sad look? Say, on the contrary, I didn't tell you this to break your heart. I told you this so that you can amend things with the prince. He will still and forever love you. I know so.
I don't know. I still can't believe I've been under some trick. You know, Danny never meant anything serious with me.
Of course, he meant a lot for you, but Mana didn't give me details though. I still don't know why.
Listen, I love the relationship between you and the prince. And the truth is, he needs you right now more than ever. And everything you heard from Barbara about me is the truth. Yes. I wrote about you just to get him jealous and to sit up and to make you his wife, according to his father's wishes. You're the only one that can fill in the blank space and take him back to his kingdom.
No, darling. I don't get it. Are you saying you never loved me all this way? Like, what? So, everything Barbara told me about you is true. You know what? To hell with both you and the prince. I'm sick and tired of this game.
No, no, no.
Okay?
No, no. Please listen to me, okay? The prince loves you. I like you, but I can't have you. okay? Just give me a chance. Make this work. He's done everything possible to prove his love to you, and I cursed it because, like I said, it was for my selfish interest. I wrote about you just to make him get jealous, and he's jealous about it. Please.
So, everything Barbara told me is true. I mean,
yes.
The other night in the club, it was your plan. Was it? It was you who drugged me. Oh no. Oh no. And the police tried talking to me. Oh, shh. Oh no.
I know that you and I started as friends, but that has also afforded me the time to know you. That has given me the room to discover your great qualities. I know that we've had our ups and downs, but look at us, it has made us stronger. I know how you feel about me. And now more than ever, I know how I feel about you, and how I feel about you is to be with you for the rest of my life, darling. Please, my love. Will you please make me a happy man? And be my wife. I would want to spend the rest of my life with you, Jesus. My story would be incomplete without you in it. Please, baby. Make me an honorable man. Accept me as your husband, and I will spend the rest of my days. And I will spend the rest of my days making sure that you are a happy woman. Is that a yes? So, I guess it's party time. Yes, we're the baby. It's not what you had. Okay.
Wait a minute, guys. What is it?
Danny.
What?
We are your pals.
Okay.
For crying out loud, we are your pals. See, we don't want to pretend all is well when we know they are not. Man, I could have just cut with the intro and tell me what is the problem.
Calm down, Danny. Tell you what it is. Now you have done everything you can to ensure that both of us are happy.
Yes.
Right? But as it stands, we still do not know what is happening in the rest of our life. Do you understand?
Who is who?
We're talking about the woman in your life. Do you have a woman in your life? If you do, we'd like to know who she is.
Come on, guys, you're not serious. The music is wasting. Let's go, man. To hell with the party. Listen, we ain't going in there without getting the chip from this man, from Danny. See, we had a plan of walking down the aisle together, same day, same time. That's our plan. You want to destroy it?
Listen now, who you are. Alright, he's just being concerned. I'm equally concerned. It looks like we're working as a team. And we do not want to feel that we're being left out of your plans. Because you know everything about us. So we would like to know. I mean, the other day you bailed out on us. You know, we didn't know where you were at a given time. But we're worried. You gave us great concern. So all we're asking is if you have a woman in your life, and if you don't, probably help you find one.
All right, guys. First and foremost, I need to apologize for the other day.
Forget it, Danny. It's not important. Forget it.
Okay. All right, like, you're aware of my premiere of my movie, My Power, My Passion, next week. Okay, so, truth is, when I get there, the first woman to kiss me, the one.
What? What is that supposed to mean? Is she supposed to be the second Judas or something?
Oh, Judas Iscariot. Come on, let's go, John.
Friend like a brother to me, Danny. Danny, I have a surprise for you. It's a little gift from me to you.
That's a key to a car.
Yes. This is a gift for you.
This is wow. Whatever I did for you wasn't this way. I mean, it's a friend and a brother. So I don't expect you to repay me for a key to a car.
Okay.
But then again, you know I've got cars. Like
fleet
of cars.
I do.
So I can't really afford to take it.
See, Danny, I know you can buy any car you want. You can even buy a fleet of cars in one day. But it's for what you've done for me. This is a little gift from me to you. Please accept it. Please accept it. Alright?
Okay, if you insist.
I do insist.
Thank you.
I have another surprise for you,
Dan. Another surprise? Another house again?
Oh, not a house this time. But,
I'm listening.
Danny, I don't know how you would feel about this. I have actually been keeping it from you for a very long time, but I feel this is the right time to let it out.
Okay, I'm listening.
Danny.
Hey, come on, get on with it, man. Just don't make me anxious, okay?
I'm getting married to your sister.
What?
Like a madman. I've been to your house, it was open and there was nobody in the house. What is wrong with you?
And what business do I have with you, Mr. Man? What business do I have with you? Haven't I told you not to call my home, my cell phone, nor come anywhere around me? Haven't I? Now listen, to save your heaven-richest man of a father, the embarrassment of not having a son to succeed him when he dies, please stay out my way. Daniel, whatever your mama calls you, stay out my way. I beg you in the name of whatever you believe in, stay out my way.
Listen, you can't do this. What's wrong with you? The fact that you lost your job doesn't mean you've lost your destiny. You know what? I'm going to help you. Okay, let me be of help to you. Let's talk.
We have nothing to talk about. Okay? Just go! Go away! You agent of destruction.
Wait, hold on. This is all about Laura? This is all about Laura, right? You know what? You can suck for all I care.
You always use anger to spoil your time of visitation.
I overheard you and my brother. Do you always have to quarrel with him over issues of the past? And now? He came to give you your letter. But you were too angry to say it.
What letter?
He sacked your boss and made you the chief of IT in all my father's company.
Jesse, please, if this is a joke, just stop it. I don't like it at all. Please stop it. Please, just stop this joke.
He called me this morning to witness it. And that is why I came here for us to celebrate. But no. You guys were busy embarrassing yourselves.
Desi. No, you can't be serious. Desi, are you serious about this? Oh my God. Desi, are you serious?
Come, I got it!
Woo!
Where are you?
What's the matter in my office?
Look at this, baby! Look at this!
We are pleased to inform you that you are hereby appointed as the Chief Information Technology Supervisor of Donald Integrated Systems Limited. Please assume your duty as soon as possible. Signed, Daniel, Managing Director.
Yes! Yes!
I'm so happy for you!
Truth is, when I get there, the first woman to kiss me is gone.
What? What is that supposed to mean? Is she supposed to be the second Judas or something?
Oh, Judas Iscariot. Come on, let's go,
John. This is my bride to be.
Barbara is the second Judas.
Second Judas.
Wow! This is serious! Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations!
Thanks, man!
This is good!
So you see, it's not a full circle.
Oh, a full circle.
Full circle.
Yeah.
Full circle.
Oh.
Is it how?